हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रतिभा सोनूने, फैकल्टी ऑफ श्री जैन विद्या प्रसारक मंडल्स, रसिकलाल एम धारीवाल कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी, चिंचवड, पुणे. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ क्लिनिकल फार्मसी. आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इंट्रोडक्शन टू क्लिनिकल फार्मसी, स्कोप ऑफ क्लिनिकल फार्मसी, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ क्लिनिकल फार्मसी, role of clinical pharmacist and different constraints in development of clinical pharmacy. First we'll see the definition and what do we mean by clinical pharmacy. Clinical pharmacy is a newborn discipline that carries traditional hospital pharmacist from his product oriented approach to more healthier patient oriented approach, so as to ensure maximum well-being of the patient while on drug therapy. Or you can define clinical pharmacy as it is the branch of pharmacy which is concerned with various aspects of patient care and deals not only with dispensing of drug but also advising the patients on safe and rational use of the drugs. We'll see now scope of clinical pharmacy. First, medication history. It includes past and present of prescriptions and non-prescription drugs, dietary supplements, dietary habits, drug and estimate of patient compliance with the drug therapy. Second, monitoring drug therapy. It includes evaluation of patient pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamic parameters, laboratory findings, medical problems and communicating relevant findings to physician. Third, participation in ward rounds. The clinical pharmacist with physicians should participate in ward rounds, observe individual patient and decide the drug therapy. Drug information. The clinical pharmacist should establish drug information centers to the pharmacy department. The drug information is available at the center and utilized suitably. This data is sent to physician as per their requirements. Fifth, patient counseling. It involves providing information to the patient about drug therapy and illnesses. The pharmacist acts as resource for information about health promotion and disease prevention. Participation in new drug investigations. Clinical pharmacist along with physician participates in investigation of new drugs. Data of this investigation is compiled, analyzed and maintained at the drug information centers. ADR management. ADR means adverse drug reaction management. Along with physician, clinical pharmacist activity is involved in the reporting of management of ADR. Educational programs. Clinical pharmacist organized educational programs for nursing and education related to safe and effective use of the drugs. Ninth, tailoring drug therapy. The clinical pharmacist after the diagnosis of physician formulates drug therapy to the need of the patient. Now we'll see different objectives of the clinical pharmacist. First, it provides pharmaceutical care related to monitoring of drug therapy, which improves quality of life of patients. Second, it gives opportunity to assist the physician in doing a better job of prescribing and observing drug therapy. Third, it involves proper decision and judgment on deciding the drug therapy to avoid adverse effects or to discontinue the drug therapy. Fourth, it offers opportunity to educate the patients by involving them in the process of drug utilization. Fifth, it shows the rational use of drug by using professional knowledge of pharmacy. Sixth, it enhances the effectiveness, safety, potency and accurate drug therapy. Seventh, it has basic aim to give maximum drug efficiency reduce the drug toxicities and provide cost effectiveness of the drug. Now, what should be the role of clinical pharmacist during the drug therapy to the patient? First, prepare medication histories for patient's permanent medical record. Second, it helps in selecting and monitoring of drug therapy, in deciding the dose and dosage schedule by using pharmacokinetic consideration of the drug and patient disease status, is monitoring drug therapy. Third, arranging educational and training programs. Clinical pharmacist is responsible for arranging seminars on drug use and review and patient care programs. Fourth, they provide consultation regarding IV therapy, TPN, clinical pharmacokinetic selection of the drug therapy. Fifth, clinical pharmacist is involved in drug administration and drug distribution in patient care area. Sixth, establishes and monitor a system to ensure proper storage of pharmacy items such as insulin and other biological products. Seventh, defects and diagnosis, adverse drug reactions and drug interactions. Eighth, participating in emergency situations of patients. For example, drug overdoses, toxic reactions in the body, poisoning, providing first aid treatment. Ninth, participation in clinical investigation. It involves clinical drug trial on animal. He participate in such activity with physician investigators. Now we'll see different constraints and barriers in development of clinical pharmacy. First, there is a lack of discussion about the problems in regarding the drug. Second, owners resist clinical pharmacy practice because it must not give commercial benefit to them. Third, medical professionals or doctors consider clinical pharmacy as interference in their work. Fourth, undergraduate students do not have sufficient knowledge to perform practice of clinical pharmacy. There is confusion about the role of pharmacist in national health services. There is lack of jobs as clinical pharmacist. And lastly, pharmacists should know needs of patients and physician progress in education and training of pharmacist will result in growth of clinical pharmacy. Hope all of you have understood the introduction of the clinical pharmacy successfully. Thank you.